Hey, hi, welcome to this lecture on understanding C basic data types. So in this lecture, what are we going to see? We're going to see a very simple thing as how does compiler handles the basic data type. The basic data type of interest that we're talking are integers and short, as well as character and long, but we'll be focusing on integer and short. Now before going to that, let's recollect what we learned in the last lecture. Last lecture we saw that now compiler generates an assembly instructions for C code. This is too dark. And compiler assigns addresses and variables, addresses to global variables and function in the executable file. So in the final executable file is created, all the global variables are assigned addresses and value. Compiler assigns addresses and value. The executable file contains addresses of all global variables and its value as well. The final executable is created, you would know where the address of each global variable is, each function is, and for global variables, the initial value of global variable is also present in the executable. Then the executable file is read by the loader, and the loader loads the program and the data into the processor memory and starts executing it. So this is what we saw in the last lecture. So we're going to look at an important property called length and placement. So we look at what is length and placement for basic data types. Now consider two variables, ix and is. Ix is an integer, is a short variable. And here we have said that ix is 4 bytes. So who decides the length of integer? So length of integer is decided by the compiler. The compiler looks at some aspect of the processor architecture and decides what is the length. So in this processor architecture, for example, ARM Cortex-M3, the GCC compiler has decided the length of integer to be 4 bytes. And similarly, it has decided the length of short to be of 2 bytes. Okay. So each compiler, the length of integer will change as per the architecture. The compiler will dictate it, but it look at certain aspect of architecture to dictate the length of the integer. Similarly, length of short and length of character is dictated by the compiler. Now, another important aspect is the arrangement of bytes. Now, what arrangement of bytes is this? Assume that the compiler has said that variable ix resides at the address 1000 and it contains 4 bytes, 1000, 1001, 1002, 1003. So 1000 is the least significant address or the lower address, and 1003 is the highest address of the variable ix. So ix starts at address 1000 and ends at address 1003. Now in a big endian, the most significant byte of a variable resides at lower address. So what is the most significant byte of the variable ix? The most significant byte of the variable ix is a. So that resides in the least lower address, which is 1000. So most significant byte resides at the lower address. And so that pattern follows after that. The next significant byte is BB. Okay, it will correspond, it will be at the next higher address, and the least significant byte, which is DD, will be at the highest address corresponding to the variable IX. So DD is the least significant byte of variable IX that will be present in the highest address of the variable IX. So that is big endian. Extrapolating for short, consider a short variable IS, and the compiler, if it is assumed given a variable an address of 1004, the short will be present at address 1004 and 1005. Now the most significant byte of IX is EE. That will reside at the lower address. So lower address is 1004. So EE resides at 1004, FF resides at 1005. So this is the big endian. And the little endian is a different arrangement. In this, the most significant byte resides at the highest address. So let's take IX again. IX spans the address 1000, 1001, 2003. The highest address is 1003. Now, what is the MSB? The MSB in this case is again AA. The AA is the MSB. So AA is the MSB of the variable IX. That will reside at the highest address. The highest address of this is 1003, so AA resides at address 1003. And the least significant byte is DD, that will reside the lowest address, so that is 1000. So this is called little endian. So there are two arrangements, little endian and big endian. Same will be applicable for short. short is it begins at address 1004. It has two bytes, 1004 and 1005. The most significant byte of IS is nothing but EE. Now, so where does EE reside? EE will reside at the highest address. So highest address is 1005. So that is why this will reside. Now, this is completely the processor architecture. This is how when I write to a variable, when I write to a variable IS, this is how the underlying architecture, processor architecture will store it in this byte format. So it's up to the processor to store it. And we will see why it is important later. But this is a characteristics of processor. If you take a look at the memory, it will be this arrangement. The first byte will be FF, the second byte will be EE. This is how it will be present inside the processor for a short variable for a little Indian architecture. Okay. Hopefully you understood the big Indian and little Indian architecture. So let's go ahead further and let's see about what memory access. So let's take an C code that says x equals y plus 2, where x and y are both integers. Now one C statement, like we said, the compiler translates the C code into assembly code. So in this case, what the compiler has done is it has translated x equals y plus 2 to these three assembly statements. So what the assembly statements do is, first statement reads the value address of y into register R0. Second statement adds R0 to 2 and moves to R1. And third one writes back R1 to the address x. So it's just performing the value of x equals y plus 2. And the compiler has done two things. It's what it has already done is it has assigned the variable y the address of 1000 and the variable x the address of 1004. So the compiler has produced the assembly instructions and it has also produced assigned addresses to global variables. So finally, these three will be the instructions produced by the compiler. Okay, so let's take what happens when you execute the instruction load word R0 to 1000 at address 1000 is the variable y. So because of this instructions, R0 will get the value of 100, right? You can see R0 getting value of 100. The next instructions add 2 to R0 and write to R1. So R1 will become 102. The third instruction actually goes and writes R1 to the address location 1004. Right? So at the end of after this execution, what will happen is the address 1004 will get the value of 102. Right? So after this instruction is executed, which means x becomes 102. So that's what this is doing. If you take from C perspective, x equals y plus 2 means take the value of y, add 2 and write it to x. And y was initially 100. So 100 plus 2 is 102. And that's what happens. After executing this instruction, the address location 1004 become 102, and which corresponds to x. So x becomes 102. So what I'm saying is that x equals y plus 2 boils down to three instructions. And one C statement can boil down to multiple assembly instructions. That's what this is trying to show. Similarly, instead of x equals 2, I can also have x equals 2. X equals y plus 2. Instead of x equals y plus 2, I can have x equals 2 also. In such a case, when I say x equals 2, then you can say it boils down to two assembly instructions. But first, it's moving R0 with the value of 2. And then it's writing to the memory location x. So as a result of this, this assembly statement gets 2. So you can see that a variable can be assigned multiple ways. You can assign a variable a constant value. You can assign it any kind of an expression. Or you can just assign to another variable, right? So variable can be take value from multiple sources. It can be taken from a constant, from an expression, or from another variable. So we'll introduce a concept called lValue and rValue at this point of time. So when you say typically x equals expression, an expression can be just a constant. X equals 2 is possible. You can have an expression such as x equals x plus 2 also, right? Which is an expression which is involving plus operation. So there are two constants. One thing which you need to know is that as far as the compiler is concerned, the right hand side will always evaluate to an expression, to a value. It will evaluate a numerical value, right? So when you say compiler, it will evaluate a numerical value. So y x equals y plus 2, we saw how y's initial value is 100, x becomes 102. But the variable y plus 2 did evaluate to the constant, you did evaluate to the integer value or a value of 102. So every expression evaluates to a value, and that value is called the rValue. rValue is nothing but a value. It's a number. There's a number associated with it. Whereas lValue actually corresponds to a variable. So basically to that variable, to the variable x, you are assigning a value. Right? So that's why there are two concepts called lValue and rValue. So moving on further. Okay, so let's build this up. So we say a equals 4. What this means is that take the constant value of 4 and assign it to the variable a. Okay, now one thing about compiler is this whole statement a equals 4 itself evaluates to an expression or evaluates to a value. So a equals 4 evaluates to a value of 4. So when you do b equals a equals 4, what the compiler is going to do, it's going to first evaluate this expression b equals a equals 4. Now a equals 4 evaluates to the expression of 4. So as a result of which b becomes 4. So even having an equal to is also an expression. A equals 4 is also an expression. So every expression or every statement, its assignment statement, boils down to an expression. When you do b equals a equals 4, first the compiler will say evaluate a equals 4, that becomes 4, and hence b will become 4. Now let's take one more code called b equals a equals 5. Now in this case, what we have done is we have said that first evaluate b equals a. So we say b equals a, now the current value of a is 4. So b equals a will evaluate to a value of 4. So this statement would become 4 equals 5. But 4 equals 5 is completely meaningless statement because this left hand side must evaluate to a variable. Only the right hand side can become a value. So b equals a equals 5 is illegal because b equals a evaluates to 4, and 4 equals 5 is meaningless because this left hand side must correspond to a variable. So the compiler will say left hand side is not an lValue and give you an error. One other thing which I want to state here is if you do a plus 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 plus, right? Now a plus plus, if a is 4, a plus plus will become 5. Again, 5 is nothing but a value. It is not an lValue. It's just a pure constant or it's a value. 5 plus plus is meaningless. So again here the compiler will throw out an error, right? So from this we come to know that in a statement a equal to b, or in a statement of the type lValue equals rValue, the rValue is nothing but an expression. It has to be an expression. The lValue corresponds to a variable. It corresponds to an address that needs to be updated. Let's fix just to a variable. The rValue may also contain a variable, but one needs to understand if a equals b is there, both play a different role. This b plays a value, role of a value, and a plays the role of a variable on which you write r. So write r value is always an expression. Okay. So the l value, hopefully the difference between l value and r value is clear. So in summary, what we saw that what we discussed so far and what we saw is that the size of basic type is decided by the compiler. It's integer, character, short. It's decided by the compiler. It's based on the architecture, the underlying processor for which the code is generated. So for each processor and each compiler pair, the compiler will decide for this architecture whether the size of integer is 4 bytes, 8 bytes, or whatever it is. The byte ordering, whether it's big endian or little endian, is decided by the underlying architecture. The byte order has to be known by the programmer if he or she wants to manipulate integer as bytes. We'll see that later, but this is very essential. One needs to know, if you're working on low-level programming and if you're operating on bytes, you definitely need to know how the individual bytes of an integer are stored. The l value equals r value. This l value equals r value here, we saw that the r value is nothing but an expression, and the lValue is nothing but a variable. So every lValue equals rValue, rValue becomes an expression and it evaluates to a particular value, an integer value or a value. It has a value associated with it. It has lValue is the name of a variable. We also saw that lValue equals rValue is for a statement like this. This itself evaluates to an expression. Right, when you say b equals a equals 4, as far as the compiler is concerned, first it will do a equals 4 and this evaluates to a value of 4. And that's why every expression evaluates to a value. So next b is assigned the 4, so b becomes 4, hence b equals 4 evaluates to the expression 4. So every expression evaluates to a specific value, even assignment. Statement like b equals a equals 4 also has a value associated with it. And next we'll get introduced to the concept of an operator. Okay, thank you. Thank you.